BlueHalo, a defense technology firm focused on transforming global defense solutions, has successfully launched its Freedom Eagle 1 FE-1 missile for the first time. This new weapon is being developed for the U.S. Army's Next-Generation Counter-Uncrewed Aerial System (CUAS) program. The live-fire demonstration of the FE-1 controlled test vehicle took place from January 16th to 18th this year at Yuma Proving Ground in Arizona, though details of the event were only recently disclosed. This test was conducted under the Next-Generation C-UAS Missile (NGCM) program, which seeks to expand the U.S. munitions industry's capacity to address evolving aerial threats, particularly drones. Designed to be cost-effective and easily mass-produced, the FE-1 is part of the Army's broader initiative to counter the growing drone threat more effectively. Jonathan Moneymaker, BlueHalo's chief executive officer, stated, "In light of recent global events, including activities in Europe, the Red Sea, and Taiwan, we're taking a proactive stance, increasing internal investments to advance our FE-1 system and leaning in to meet the demand signal on an expedited timeline." In this video, Defense Updates reports on the BlueHalo Freedom Eagle 1 missile. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The CTV live-fire demonstration at Yuma Proving Ground involved three missile test flights. The company stated, "In each of the three tests, FE-1 launched successfully and performed its flight as planned, affirming BlueHalo's commitment to a rapid development schedule. The team collected video, system, and sensor data logs, radar tracks, and RF diagnostics data from each flight test to evaluate the missile's guidance, navigation, and control systems, and analyze aerodynamic models to drive down the significant technical risks associated with the program." The FE-1 launcher used for the Yuma test was mounted on a flatbed trailer and was a simple cage-like construction for a single missile, apparently intended only as a test rig. The missile will likely be available with a four-round box-type launcher, which could be mounted on Stryker 8x8 or on warships. BlueHalo was selected in June 2024 by the U.S. Army Combat Capabilities Development Command Aviation and Missile Center, CCDC AVMC, Aviation and Missile Technology Consortium, AMTC, as one of two vendors to advance the NGCM program. The other vendor is Raytheon, which is fielding the Coyote system. The development of the FE-1 is part of a larger project to expand air defense capabilities, with BlueHalo's CEO, Jonathan Moneymaker, emphasizing the missile's role in providing layered protection to warfighters, allies, and assets. This initiative aligns with legislative emphasis as reflected in the Fiscal Year 2025 National Defense Authorization Act, which prioritizes enhanced CUAS capabilities. The FE-1 is designed to target larger drones classified as Group 3 and above. According to the U.S. military, Group 3 drones typically weigh between 55 pounds or 25 kilograms and 1,320 pounds or 600 kilograms, operate at altitudes from 3,500 to 18,000 feet, and reach speeds between 100 knots or 185 kilometers per hour and 250 knots or 285 kilometers per hour, 650 kilometers per hour. To address these threats, the FE-1 is engineered with enhanced maneuverability, extended range, and faster launch capabilities compared to current systems. The FE-1 has a modular architecture that allows integration with other rocket motors for greater range and maneuverability against subsonic and supersonic threats. The software-defined front end enhances flexibility and adaptability in various operational contexts. FE-1's low swap, size, weight, power demands compared to other air defense systems, facilitating easier deployment. The weapon seamlessly integrates with existing infrastructure and command and control C2 networks, as it is radar agnostic. The development timeline from paper design to first flight was remarkably quick, at 107 days, highlighting its rapid progression. Just 2 months after the company was selected, BlueHalo announced the completion of multiple rounds of testing for the FE-1, including the successful firing of its dual-thrust, solid-fuel rocket motor. As of last December, BlueHalo had completed warhead detonation testing, which provided data on penetration depths, velocities, impacts, and panel fragmentation patterns. The next step is planned to include a customer live fire demonstration in the third quarter of this year. CEO Jonathan Moneymaker stated, "It's clear that the new administration wants middle-tier acquisition going faster and fielding technology quicker. Additionally, Congress is supportive of additional effectors to get longer range at higher altitudes against a threat that is evolving faster than we can keep pace with current systems. We're moving at the speed necessary to meet the need, even if it requires our own internal funding to make it happen." Drone attacks are a rising concern, with the potential to overwhelm traditional air defense systems. Swarms of agile drones used in mass attacks are difficult to guard against. For example, on September 14, 2019, facilities of Saudi Arabia's oil company Aramco, located in the east of the country, came under coordinated drone and missile attack. Being facilities of very significant importance, they were protected by layered air defense, Patriot Pack 2 surface-to-air missile batteries and short-range automatic gun systems. The Patriot air defense failed to detect the incoming threats or was too late, and the automatic gun systems fired sporadically, but the threats were not taken down. The attack disrupted shipments of 5.7 million barrels of oil daily, which is around 50% of Saudi Arabia's output. Since then, drone tech has evolved considerably, which is evident in the Ukraine war. Apart from technical challenges, the economics of interception is also skewed and could be easily assessed from the large-scale April 2024 attack on Israel. The United States reported neutralizing over 80 drones and at least 6 ballistic missiles launched from both Iran and Yemen, where the Houthis, a militant group backed by Tehran, operate from. The operation, lasting only a few hours, came with significant financial implications. Some missiles like Israeli Arrow 3, American-made PAC-3, and SM-6 cost several millions, and in some cases, 2 to 3 may be required to neutralize a single threat. An assessment from Reem Aminoak, a former brigadier general and chief financial advisor to the Israeli military's leadership, suggests that the combined efforts of Israel, the United States, Britain, France, and Jordan likely incurred expenses in the ballpark of $1.1 billion. This is the kind of situation where BlueHalo FE-1 would be useful. The NGCM is one of at least 4 ongoing U.S. Army counter-drone initiatives. These efforts also include developing a handheld C-UAS system for soldiers in combat and a counter-drone radar. It will be interesting to see how BlueHalo FE-1 shapes up.